I now have clue how to do vlog style video with SLR camera in my left hand. I'm total hopeless, I think. Hi guys, I am here again on my YouTube channel. Sorry for this long pause, which is around 2.5 months, something like this. But I'm really busy on my daily work, and I'm also worked a lot around my studio. So I finished a lot of things around here. And this video is about a small channel update, and I just want to show you guys what I've done in my studio. So first of all, I finished here with the lobby.
90% done.
This wall, I just call it
a wall of fame.
So what I did here, I just find a lot of records in my old DJ boxes. And I also get a few records from a couple of my friends. So I placed all of the records to the wall, which is kind of my favorite list. So it's full with really great, really rare hip-hop albums and jazz rap albums or whatever. But this wall here, it's a bit more really famous people. For example, Bob Marley, Ice-T, who has Nicky D and Prince, whatever. So if I need this record, I still can pull out and I still can play on my record player. This table here is just for sitting together with the guests and with the artists, and soon I will drop here my old 55-inch LCD TV. And this one here, it's a very small kitchen with all the equipment. This hall here, it will be the house for the microwave and grill oven. And here I will build a really nice island for a professional coffee machine. Here it's a small bathroom with dash, with toilet, with sink, blah blah blah. So let me show you what's going on upstairs in the studio area.
Look at this.
You know guys, this is the chill zone in my studio, so I'm finished with that. This one is came from the Mumox, and this is actually the biggest sofa what they have. So this is 4.5 meter long sofa. But this chill zone will also work like a recording place for the guitarist guys. Because my plan here, maybe you can see, but we have enough space to place here a lot of amplifiers and speakers and the stand for the microphones. By the way, this chill zone is not 100% done at the moment, so I ordered the speaker system for the Dolby Atmos amplifier and all the cables, everything. So this is only what is missing, and a few elements for the projector system. At the moment, I just purchased this 65-inch OLED TV. At the moment is Mr. Abom doing some machining work.
Why are you looking at me?
Check out his YouTube channel. He's a really awesome guy. I really like to watch his videos. So what kind of gears I have here at the moment? Nothing fancy, just my really old analog, old-fashioned vintage hi-fi system. So my lovely Grundig amplifier, my favorite Kenwood LS770 speaker with this really nice Telefunken TLX2 monitor hi-fi speaker, and I on the end I moved here my reel-to-reel recorder, because I have a plan to buy other kind of reel-to-reel tape recorder for studio usage. Just a really short story about this curtain system. Maybe you can hear already just by my lavalier microphone, but the sound of the studio is changed a lot, thankfully, for these curtains. So the story behind these curtains. On the beginning, I ordered some really special and really expensive acoustic curtains with about 630 gram per square meter density. And I was not so happy with the results with this special material, so I sent it back the curtains. And this company is a really nice company, so they give me back all the money. But later on, I find this material in an IKEA, if you believe or not. But it has 1.2 kilogram per square meter density. So let me show you the structure of these curtains. Basically, this is the most expensive curtain in the IKEA, but unfortunately, not either the height and the width, and nothing is was good to hear. And so I bought this sewing machine, or what is this from the Zinger, and I did everything by myself. So I modified the length and the width and the structure, whatever. So let me show you the textile itself. The outside is some kind of hard textile, but the inside, it's a really soft, it's almost like some kind of foam. But between the two, there is something else. I don't know what they put inside, but now, with these curtains, I have here absolutely perfect acoustics. So everything is really silenced, high frequencies are really controlled now, there is no delay and echo, nothing. Now I will show you guys what's going on in the studio area, because this is some kind of disaster or something like this, but there is a few changes. First of all, we have here this
space station.
Yeah. So what's going on here with this rec cabinet? I always want a really professional sound studio rec cabinet, which is exactly made for sound studio usage. And finally, I find this one on a eBay Kleinanzeigen website. It was sold by a media company. Maybe they moved the location, or they changed the workflow, I don't know, or maybe they just bankrupted. Yeah, they had from this really professional, absolutely German-made cabinets a lot. But unfortunately, when I arrived today, storage, I just find over there three pieces, and from the three, I choose this one. The owner of the company, he said it was full with really expensive Pro Tools and Avid interfaces and really weird full high-tech video gears, and this cabinet, it was installed in their tracking room. Just let me show you the serial number of the cabinet, yeah? And then you can get a picture how much gear they had. So this was the 279th of cabinet, yeah? The side wall of the cabinet is a 2.5 inch or 2 inch layered wood with some kind of really weird MDF construction inside. I cannot show you at the moment. Ah, you know what? Maybe on a back panel you can see. So the inside structure, it's some kind of acoustic trick. The full cabinet is covered with this really professional acoustic foam, and I don't know what is this, but I checked this material on the internet. 1 square meter, it's about 128 euro. I did a test with this cabinet, so I just dropped under one really common normal PC with a really loud fan, and when I close the door, and when the back is installed on a rec cabinet, I'm telling you guys, nothing. Not even one piece of noises came out from it. But what the real reason behind this spaceship installation here in my studio? Soon I will change and I will upgrade my studio to completely network-based audio interfaces, which is powered by some kind of FPGA and DSP system. The reason for that, we had here a really big disaster. This is the main reason why I didn't upload nothing to the YouTube, because unfortunately my Tascam DM4800 digital workhorse, really lovely mixer, is died. So, what's the story? 2.5 months ago, I worked on the Roland MC909 project on 2, 3, 4 new episode. So I just came up here and I start to shoot and I recorded everything to the digital mixer and to my workstation. And I did 4, I'm telling you guys, 4 episode I did already. But later on when I start to work on the video, I realized I had a lot of audio problems. So the phases are switched and I get really weird noises and the EQing is gone and the compression is did really weird stuff, and time to time the Roland MC909 is just get muted and I get really weird noises from my monitor system. It doesn't matter what I switched, even if I used my headphone amplifier, I get the same kind of noise. But it was on a beginning is I heard this somehow is related to the electrical system here in the studio. 2 weeks from this pause on my YouTube channel is nothing more, just I try to find the reason for this really weird noises in the electrical system. So I did a really huge work here to open the wall, check the plugs one by one, and check all the cables one by one, and the grounding points, and the fuses, and the automatics, whatever. After 2 weeks, I realized I'm so stupid, because nothing wrong with the electrical system. So I start to look around the mixer, what's going on. And then I realized this mixer is just passed away. So what's happened in a mixer? Unfortunately, the SRAM chip is died, and this caused a lot of error and a lot of issues around the FPGAs. What you can see there is one and there is the other one, and also in the DSP system here and also the DSPs here. You can imagine all the parameters and all the fader movement and everything what you do changing in a mixing, it's stored first into the SRAM, and then all these FPGAs and all these DSPs are loading up the parameters from the SRAM. So you can imagine if one bit is jumping from 0 to 1 or from 1 to 0, this can cause a hell a lot of problem, and this is the reason why I will change the whole mixing structure and the whole interface system to some kind of new. And I think I will upload a really short video about what I chose and why I chose them. Everything is hooked up to this beautiful digital mixer. So hard to find a new system on a kind of cost-effective way which can replace this amazing workhorse. Roland MC909 project. I will shoot a new episode again. Because now at the moment I just dropped here this multi-channel field recorder. Also from Tascam. I hope he will not die on me. So I can shoot the video on a really weird way. By the way, YouTube and BMR Studio. I think in this week we will reach the 1,000 subscriber on my YouTube channel. So thank you guys for the support and for the views and for the comments and for the sharings. I think on a weekend, on Saturday or Sunday, I will do a live event to celebrate this big step on my YouTube channel. I hope you guys enjoyed it. See you next time. Bye. Yeah, green, blue, red. Oh my God. I think the red is really fit. to my style, black and red. Oh my God, beautiful, absolutely professional.